I love the drawers that I made for this desk. So I also want to make some similar drawers for this standing desk and this standing desk and Rachel's standing desk, as well as this little desk.
The problem is the standing desk's mechanism gets in the way, so the drawers have to be fairly short, but I still want them to pull out fairly far.
I'm using some wood that I found off the curb from a shelf. The garbage man didn't pick it up, and I just made sure I've got the last metal out of it.
I start by ripping these into strips that are the same width as my drawers are going to be deep. I then flatten one side on the jointer before resawing them into my drawers. And finally, planing them all to consistent thickness.
Stock all prepped with a good square end and my list of pieces I need for all the drawers. So starting with the longest, I'll see how I can best cut those out of those pieces.
With so many short pieces needed, I can avoid a lot of the defects in the wood.
Next, I'll cut the box joints in the corners like this, but first I'll do this with some test pieces I've got here. Let's see. Well, that is maybe a little bit too snug for when the glue is in there. It's good for a dry fit. So I'm going to move my position where I make the second cut a bit further along, and that will make for a slightly wider slot. So these two are not drawers, I just used some of the short leftovers to make more test pieces, and I'll turn those into boxes. And normally I use my box joint jig with a 48 tooth gear, which against a 12 tooth gear on here, puts 4 turns on the threaded rod per turn of the crank, which moves the carriage by a quarter inch, and that's useful for quarter inch box joints, but I thought I'd make them a little bit tighter this time, so I put a smaller gear on there, and this way I can cut that slot with just 2 cuts, so it actually saves a bit of time and makes the fingers a bit narrower, which for these drawers I think might be appropriate. As I clamp a bunch of work pieces in here, I always want to clamp it this way and that way, but the clamps often get in the way, but it just finally occurred to me to use one of these microjig match fit clamps, which are meant to go into dovetails that you can route, and I've never ever used that functionality, but these clamps come in so often just because they're so small at the end to get in places where other clamps can't get in. So I finished cutting the fingers for all the sides of the drawers. The other side needs to be offset by essentially the thickness of a tooth, which just happens to be the way this jig works, one turn of the crank. So I always just need to start one crank ahead, and I'll probably forget to do that. So I'm just going to move this piece of tape, which tells me where to start, over by this much, so I'll just home it to that position, and that has my offset in already.
I put a clock on the table saw to see how long it takes to cut the box joints into 4 work pieces at a time on both ends, and it turned out to be just under 90 seconds. Of course, gluing them together always takes much longer, and here I'm actually gluing one corner at a time and putting those aside. That way the glue has a chance to set a little bit and stiffen up that angle, so I don't have to worry about messing up the joints I've already glued when I'm gluing the next ones. No clamping required. And sides for 7 drawers and 2 boxes glued up.
Now I need bottoms for my drawers, and I've been going through my scraps of plywood to see which pieces fit just perfectly. This has got a lot of defects, which is why this is really good. These two, I'm not sure, that's kind of wasteful. I might cut more from the big sheet for those. Plus I've got one I don't have a scrap for.
I'm attaching the bottoms with just glue, and for these two small identical drawers, I can just use the drawers themselves as clamping holes, and I also save on clamps that way. And I did cut 2 bottoms out of a big sheet of plywood, which was really awkward because I wanted to cut them straight out of the plywood to not waste any material. I'm just too cheap that way.
Bottoms all glued on. Had to do this in 2 batches. First batch was those 4 because I don't have enough small clamps. Now I'm going to flush trim and bevel these bottoms, and I'll do that on the table saw. The These are three pairs of drawers for different standing desks, and you need something to slide on, like a rail like this, and I'd like to glue that on using spring clamps.
I made some L-shaped profiles to have something for the drawers to slide along. And some T-shaped profiles to go in between the drawers where they're side by side. And testing these for the biggest drawer that goes on my smallest desk.
And for a long drawer like this, having a slide like that is quite adequate because the drawer can slide quite a ways out without falling out. But for short little drawers like these, it's another story. Because they don't extend that far, so it's all too easy to pull them too far and it just falls out.
Okay, I think I have a solution here. The drawer still falls out if you pull it out too far, like this. But if it's just before falling out, it's still on there sturdy enough I can put this big weight on there and it holds just fine.
And the way that works is I have a second slide attached to the bottom of the drawer, and that one extends way, way back. The only reason the drawers aren't any deeper is because of the mechanism, this shaft here. So if I go further down, I can extend the slide much further. And that way, when the drawer is pulled further out, there's only a little bit of this slide that engages, but this slide prevents it from tipping forward. And I can add a stop on here so that the drawer doesn't get pulled out all the way by accident. And last time I made underdesk drawers, I made this style of handle, which I quite like. And they have a little grip on the bottom, and they kind of hide away when the drawer is closed. So now I'll make 7 drawer handles in that style. And I'm using a cove bit with a guide bearing cut off, tilted at 45 degrees, so I can use it sort of like a bullnose bit. And I just glued those to the fronts of the drawers. But it was tricky to keep that lined up as I was clamping it, so then I realized just put the drawer on its end, and that way gravity won't pull it out of alignment.
Because I cut these drawer bottoms out of random scraps, they're not the same thickness, but when I glue these things on there, these need to be at the same height with respect to this, which is why I cut into them on each one of them to basically bring them to the same thickness. And that actually has the advantage that when I glue this on there, I can just push it up against this edge, and that's much easier to line it up.
I got these mounted now. And seen from underneath, I've got my main sliding block right here, plus this little block that grabs the extra slide that keeps the drawer from tipping out. But getting all that lined up properly to work was awful. It doesn't help that the front of this desk isn't entirely flat. Also, I failed to take this little tab here into account when I took my measurements, and so I was short of space a little bit. So for the next desk, I came up with a much simpler scheme. These slides are a bit longer with just a block glued on there, and then on the drawer, these things have a block glued on here. So this is upside down right now, and if I just put the drawer in the slides and push it down on here, which would be lifting it up, those hooks go on here, and that restricts how far I come out. And that works really well, except I ended up putting this drawer in the middle here because that's the only place where these hooks will clear this part here. On the sides, I forgot to take into account the motor units come down a bit further. So these things would have to come down a bit further if I want to mount both drawers underneath here. Now for the drawers on this one, I had plenty of vertical space because the front edge of this desk is a bit thicker, so the drawers naturally came down a bit further. You can see the hooks on the back of the drawer clear that desk frame by quite a lot. So I thought these would be really easy to install, but I was wrong. When I installed them, they just jammed up. Because it turns out this hardwood edge sticks down from this plywood part by almost a millimeter, and I didn't leave enough room, so I had to actually shim these guides here so that I would always clear that hardwood edge. And the other thing that jammed was my hooks that sort of guide the drawer. I added these guides here to guide it on the side so the drawer can't go side to side, because when it's all the way out, it only overlaps the main slides by a centimeter or two, so there's nothing to keep it from racking. So by adding guides to the sides of the slides, like this thing here, that keeps it straight. Except it turns out these things weren't entirely parallel to each other, so when the drawer was pulled out, they got a bit wider and jammed against the guides. And the final catch with handles the way they are like this, there's a slight tendency to sometimes lift it when you pull it out, and if you lift it while pulling it out, it just falls straight out because the hooks don't engage.
So I'll see if that becomes a problem. If it does, I'll just add some screws in the back of those guides so they don't come out at all.
So with the drawers on the other desk offset towards the bottom, I figured instead of offsetting these hooks down a little bit, I could just offset the slides, which I did by gluing this spacer on them, and that brings everything down. So now with the drawers offset downwards with these spacers, the hook thingies on the back clear the mechanism. But now I have this big gap between the top and the handle, so I gotta fix that. I remounted the handles with a vertical offset so that they go nicely underneath here, and I was tempted to make the sides of the drawer taller, but even as it is, I can put stuff in there that is taller than the drawer and it closes just fine. And I made one of the drawers bigger so it'd be wide enough to hold a keyboard, because that's turned out to be so handy when I'm messing around with Raspberry Pi computer to have one just ready to go. So these are all FlexiSpot standing desks, which I quite like, and that's why I have three. And I also have affiliate links in the video description.